You're watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. Follow along with projects and footage with a premium download available at BorisFX.com. Stabilization is one of the most common and important VFX tasks, and Mocha Pro offers a number of different ways of how to deal with this, from full lockdown to art-directed smoothness. So in exercise 17, we are going to be looking at the Stabilize module in Mocha Pro. If you're only working with Mocha AE, you will not have the Stabilize module. It's a pro feature. You will be able to do stabilization using Mocha's data, but you'll just have to do it a bit more manually. Full details of that, go back to exercise 5, where we look at the right way to use tracking data. All right, so let's start with our first shot, which is this shaky lion cup. Let's play this through and have a little look. And we can see that, despite all best efforts to keep it stable, there are lots of jerky movements going around, making this a bit trickier to watch than it should be. So the first thing we have to do is obviously to track this. And where we track is very important for what style of stabilization we get, because obviously the object we track and get the tracking data for is going to be the basis for our stabilization. Now, if we're stabilizing out the entire shot, or if we're trying to stabilize out the entire shot, what we don't want to track is an object that is moving. So, tracking the lion cub itself would be a very bad idea, because that face moving is not the same as the camera movement that we're trying to get rid of. I would also counsel against tracking anything too close to the camera, because this will stabilize up that area, but we'd still end up having quite a bit of movement going around in the background. Because of parallax, the stuff that's close to the camera moves more than the stuff further away. So with that in mind, if we're just trying to get an overall stabilized area tracked up, I would probably go for something in the middle distance. Not necessarily the far distance, and nothing at the back here, but in the middle distance around here. So something around about that. Let's just see if those plants move. If those plants move, this isn't going to be a good thing anyway. They do not seem to move independently of the camera, which is good. So I think we were lucky that the wind wasn't blowing very much that day. And we can maybe extend it out a little bit, so we have this good solid brick or stone wall, I should say, in the back. Now, when it comes to the type of motion that we're tracking, we need to think long and hard about this and sort of really judge what's actually going on in the camera itself. Now, this might seem to be just like a simple translation problem where we can sort of stabilize out just position and get this looking right. But I think if we have a little look there, that distortion there is actually, I'm not sure. It's one of two things. It's either going to be a little bit of rolling shutter distortion, which is definitely not good, and it's not something that Mocha is specifically designed to get rid of, or it could be just a little bit of perspective movement, so where the camera sort of tilts just a little bit. With this shot, I'm going to track in, or I'm going to track the motion of everything, including perspective. Now, the nice thing about the stabilize module, when we look at it, is we don't have to use all of this data. But if we've got it all tracked in, it means that we can use it if necessary. So let's show our surface, let's show our grid, just to check that what we're tracking in is actually good. And track that forwards. This should be no problem for Mocha to track. Good stuff. And if we play that through, the grid is certainly seeming to stick to the background. So that's a very, very good sign. Okay, so now we want to do our stabilization, and we need to get into the stabilize module. Now, the stabilize module doesn't appear in the Essentials workspace. So what we can do is either move into Classic to bring up our parameters down at the bottom, Or, let's go back into Essentials for a second, we can always right-click in the Essentials and turn on the parameters down here. So that means we keep our Essentials tools and general layout, but we just have access to the other modules. Either way you want to work it is going to be fine. And I'm going to come into Stabilize. And let's just zoom this to fit again. And without doing anything else, I'm just going to hit play just so you can see what's going on. And I'll turn off my surface and my grid. Okay, so this is starting to look a bit smoother. We're still not completely smooth. We've got a bit of jitter, but you can see that, you know, we now have the telltale black borders, which means that things are being stabilized up around our background. So this is a good start. And let's look now down at the bottom in the parameters to see what these tools are doing. I'm going to skip over the input and we're going to skip over fixed frames. We will come back to fixed frames shortly. I'm going to have a look at smooth. So this is where we're going to be doing most of our work because this determines what motion we're going to be stabilizing out and how we're going to be stabilizing it. So at the moment, I'm just stabilizing out the X and Y translation. If I want to, I can just stabilize out horizontal or just stabilize out vertical problems. Let's turn those both on. And I can also stabilize out rotation and zoom. We don't really have much zoom in here. But you can see the more options that I turn on, the more stable things are getting with this shot. Because we do have X, Y translation and rotation problems. Now, unlike the track motion options, where if we wanted to track in rotation, we also had to track in scale. When we're stabilizing things out, we don't have to stabilize out things in order. There isn't that same hierarchy that there is with the track motion options. So if you only want to stabilize out position and scale, sorry, X and Y translation and zoom, as it's called in Stabilize, then we can do that. We don't have to add in rotation. And I can also stabilize out perspective, and you can see that moving. And everything's starting to slot into place. Now, these options, the shear and perspective, rotation and zoom, will not have any effect unless we've tracked their motion in up here, obviously. So if we only track in translation, we're only going to be able to stabilize out translation. If we only track translation, scale, and rotation, then obviously the shear and perspective aren't going to do anything. Let's turn these off. I just want to play this back for you. Let's have that selected. I'm going to turn on my view controls so I can just turn off the overlays. We saw this in the roto section. And this is how it's looking currently with translation, rotation, and zoom. But it doesn't seem to have stabilized out everything. And why is that? And the big reason for that is actually this thing here, the number of frames. And what does this number of frames relate to? Well, it relates to smoothing. This is what this section's called. So if I have a large number of frames, then Mocha's going to be smoothing out the data across a larger number of frames. So we're getting much more stable in this case. If I take this down lower, it's only smoothing out with the data from the frames a little bit before and after, so we're not quite getting as smooth a result. This is really useful for taking out small jitters in a shot without taking out the whole camera movement. Now I can turn on maximum smoothing, which is going to give me a full stabilize. And this is almost like the stabilize that we saw when we were in exercise 5, doing the manual stabilization with the inverse Mocha data. And it's looking pretty good, but it's still not looking 100% stable up at the top. So why is that? Well, look at our motion. we're still only stabilizing out the X and Y translation, rotation and zoom. If I turn on all motion now, so it's stabilizing out all motion with maximum smoothing, let's play that back. We now have a nicely, fully stabilized out shot. Hopefully fully stabilized out. If it's not being completely stable in this section here, it means that our tracking data is wrong. You know, that's one of the reasons why I love using the stabilize to check my track. Even if I don't want to actually stabilize out the shot, I'll check my tracking data by coming into the stabilize module, turning on all motion and maximum smoothing, and just see if there's any unexpected movement within my track. So it's a great way of double checking your track. If we're happy with how this is, we're going to deal with the borders at a later date. I'm happy with how the stabilization is, though. We can either export out that stabilized tracking data, just as we would do if we were exporting out, you know, regular tracking data. Or if I save and exit and we go back into our host, we can come into the module render section and I can choose my module. In this case, it's going to be stabilize. Click on render. Let's just do a quick RAM preview on that. And that will show our nice stabilized shot and we can, you know, do whatever we need to do with this. If I just wanted to scale it up to get rid of the black borders, I can do that here. You know, we're still getting a tiny bit of movement down the bottom here, mainly because that movement is to do with the rolling shutter problems that we have with this particular camera. So we're not going to be able to get rid of that, but it's a much smoother and more, you know, usable shot than it was when it started out, where it was just going all over the place and not even in a nice jittery move. It was just jittery and horrible. So that's the basics of the stabilize module. So we find the area we want to stabilize around. If we were taking out camera movement, that's probably going to be somewhere in the middle distance. When we're tracking, we choose the type of motion that we have in the shot, not just the type of motion that we want to stabilize out. And in the stabilize module itself, we can choose whether we're going to smooth or lock down a shot just by changing up the smoothness number of frames and choose what type of motion we're taking out, which doesn't have the same hierarchy as when we were doing the tracking. And when we come back, we're going to look at a slightly trickier shot and really start to understand why it's important where we track and why using Mocha Pro stabilize module often gives better results than just the automatic stabilization. All right, so I'll see you in the next part of exercise 17, the stabilize module. You've been watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. To download all videos, projects, and footage, purchase the premium version available at BorisFX.com.